Welcome back to the CheckMK channel, and in this episode we're taking a look at parents and network topology. Today's subjects are the parents and a network topology, and I'll show you how you can use them to prevent unnecessary notifications. Once again, we'll be using our test system for this video. So once again, we're back in our small distributed setup. We have a total of 10 hosts. Let's quickly go to monitor and all hosts. So we have 4 database servers. We have 2 CheckMK servers. We've got a web server and 3 switches. Now let's go to monitor and then network topology. And here we have this cloud-like diagram. Each of our CheckMK sites are depicted by this purple node. And then all the nodes around it, these are the hosts that are being monitored by that site. All the green nodes, these are hosts which are up, which currently don't have a problem. Then there is this red host, which is down. But other than that, this whole thing doesn't tell me a lot. So now let's create a more interesting topology and talk about why we would do this. Besides our database servers, our web server and CheckMK servers, we also have 3 switches. And now let's assume that these 4 database servers are only accessible via switch 1. Then what would happen if that switch were to go down? Well, then our 4 database servers would no longer be accessible for a monitoring system, and would also get the status down. And that will result in a lot of notifications, not only for the switch, but also for the database servers. It would be more useful to receive a notification regarding the issue of the switch, including the information that the database servers downstream are no longer accessible for the monitoring system. And for this, there is a status in CheckMK called unreachable. And if that's the case, then you will normally not receive any notifications regarding the database servers because you already received one for the switch. And it could be the case that the database server is working perfectly fine and even accessible for the users, just not for the monitoring system. And to make this work, we need to configure in CheckMK that the database servers are being accessed over the switch. And for that, there is a property called parents. So now let's go ahead and edit one of our hosts. So as always, go to setup and then hosts. And then to the Munich folder, servers, and let's edit DB2 server. Now there is this property called parents. So let's check the box. And now we can select the parent host. And we'll pick switch number 1. So now let's simply save and then activate our changes. And if we now head back to our network topology, so monitor and then network topology, you see that it's still the same diagram. And in order to see the children, we have to increase the number of hops. So now you see that DB server 2 is connected to switch 1. And the direction of the lines indicates in which direction the data is flowing. So you see here, it goes from DB server 2 to switch 1 and then to the monitoring site. And now CheckMK knows that in order to reach the database server, it needs to go through this switch. So when a switch would go down, it knows that it should not be able to reach the database server. And now let's do the same for all other database servers. So let's head back to the host configuration. First, we will remove the parent from from DB server 2. Save. And now instead of setting the parent explicitly on all servers, we can also go back to Munich here and then edit the folder servers. So now let's set the parent on the folder level. Switch number one. Again, save and activate the changes. And now let's go back to our network topology. Increase the number of hops again. And now you see that every single host in that folder is connected to switch one. So whenever we add a new host to that folder, it will automatically, or CheckMK will automatically know that it's only accessible over switch one. Next thing we should do is try if this actually works. And how can we do that? Well, switch one has to go down. So then we can see what would happen. But because this is a test system, I cannot simply turn off the switch. So we have to do a little trick. If we right click on the host and then go to details of host, and then edit the host property. So click on the host name, then host, host configuration. So instead of turning off the switch, we will simply change the IP address a little. Activate changes. So now our host or CheckMK should assume that our host is down. Increase the number of hops. Now you see switch one is down. You also see that DB server one is now unreachable. It was previously down, but now CheckMK assumes that it's down likely because of the fact that switch one is down. You might ask yourself why the other three database servers did not go to the unreachable state. Normally in a real system, they probably would, but because this is a test system and CheckMK is still able to ping these hosts, they will remain up. So that means if CheckMK is still able to reach the hosts, even though that the parent is down, they will remain up and CheckMK will keep monitoring them as usual. But what if you have a system with redundant switches? So if the hosts were accessible over more than one switch, well then as long as one of the switches is functional, then the host behind it should still be accessible. And in that case, you won't have a tree structure, but a meshed structure. And you can also configure this in CheckMK. So once again, let's go to the host configuration. So set up host. And let's go back to the folder we were editing. And you might have seen this already before. Here at the parent, you can select multiple parents. So let's add one. Let's add switch two. So once again, save and activate. Now let's head back to the network topology. Increase the number of hops. And you see that it became a bit more cluttered. And that's because all these servers are now connected to both switch one and to switch two. So switch two and switch one are connected to the side and all other servers are connected to these switches. And you'll also see that now DB server one is not longer unreachable, but down. Because CheckMK sees that it should be accessible over switch one and two, and one of them is functional. So it knows that the problem lies with the host itself, with DB server one, and not with the switch. As you can see, you have the ability in CheckMK to map your network's topology, primarily to avoid unnecessary alerts. And when we talk about network topology in CheckMK, then we mean the topology from the point of view of the monitoring system. So how CheckMK reaches the hosts and not your network topology in general. And if you have a distributed setup, then every site has its own topology. And that's because the monitoring takes place locally from the site. So if you configure your network topology in CheckMK correctly, you can avoid a lot of unnecessary alerts. And this is absolutely recommended, especially if you have a few sites with a large amount of hosts that are only accessible over a few routers or switches. So that was it again for this episode about network topology. I hope it was helpful to you. If so, subscribe to our channel and like the video. See you next time.